Hi everyone, and welcome to today's mini training series featuring timbral trills and fingerings on the oboe. As an oboist, I love timbral fingerings because you could say they let me cheat when I want to make a note softer or when I want to make a note rounder and brighter. But I also do think that timbral fingerings can add a lot of dynamic qualities to music when they are used in a piece. An example of this is Barrio Sequenza 7. In this, he takes the B natural, which only uses one finger on the oboe, and he uses five new fingerings that, as they progress from alternate fingering 1 to alternate fingering 5, they get more and more muffled. So I'll show you what they sound like. As they go on, they have different colors and different dynamic qualities and properties. Another way that I like to use timbral fingerings is in timbral trills. Timbral trills, I think, add a lot of spice to the music or give a note a little bit of color. A great example of a piece that I like the timbral trills in is Scott McAllister's Grunge Concerto. I'll play a little bit for you. Just a few simple notes, but by adding that timbral trill, it just gives it a whole new dynamic color and meaning. Timbral trills and fingerings on the oboe are very easy to write for. The less fingers that are used in the original fingering, such as B natural, only uses one, the more opportunities there are for alternate fingerings. If you'd like to use a timbral trill in your work, you can notate it as a trill sign and just write timbral trill or resonance trill above it. For timbral fingerings, you can find a timbral fingering that you would like the oboist to use and notate it in the music or the performance notes, or you can just indicate it with a hollow circle above the notes. Thank you.